Your mistake was jacking that you cute. No one we know where you live. But when I texted you and asked you what was up, you was fronting like our spare time while we was waiting for y'all. So we ended up getting, I have the receipts. He could never say, you want my name for clout, y'all collab for clout. We live in the peas. I don't have no problem with nobody living in a project, but you cannot live in a project and think that you're gonna play with me. Y'all know I don't even do story times. I don't even get into the messy stuff. But let me tell y'all about how I did a collab with this boy. He started telling everybody he killed. Are you dumb, boy? And look at me. I look a mess. But it's okay because I still look better than everybody. You got my evil twin right here to confirm or deny the facts. I don't know why she got her back to us or whatever. Like, but anyways, y'all. I don't know if I should start giving y'all dates.
I mean, don't tell me because I'll name drop. I never even cut.
If y'all want a name drop, go subscribe to her YouTube channel. And if y'all get her to, what we at? If y'all get her to 400 subs, she's going to name drop. Are y'all dumb? You peeing?
Look, y'all, she pissing.
Yeah, I'm not going too in depth on the timeline or whatever. But long story short, it was 3 weeks ago, right before I came back to college. I know I'm in college. I'm back in college. And that's all I need to. All right, y'all, so approximately 3 weeks ago, me and Tori went to go do a collab with a boy. So first, the first red flag was that he made us meet him at a chicken spot. So we met the boy at a chicken spot under the train station. We was standing out there waiting for like a good hour. So disregard the fact that we was already out there for an hour, we should have left. That was the first red flag. Then he gets there and he comes with another boy. So it's 2 and 2. That wasn't the plan. It was originally supposed to be me and Tori and him. But cool, you brung your friend. That's nothing. Like, it got nothing to do with none of that. So before anything happened, we made it really clear. Like, I'm not a type. We're not the females that's going for 20 versus 1, smash a pass, blind dates. We're not going for none of that. So first, he pull up and we still, when he get there with his friend, he's still like beating around the bush, not making no time. We not moving. So whole time, boy lived on the corner from where we was at, but it took them a whole hour to get where we was at. So say this, the red line that you see right here, that's the chicken spot, and the TV is where he live at. So literally, we could see his crib from where we was standing, but it took him an hour to get to where we was at. So it already was given the line. Like, I'm sorry, I'm stuttering and stuff. I'm getting mad. It was already given the line, but we feel me, like, I'm not going for that. So boom. We get there, and then next thing you know, a third and a fourth boy pop up. Where y'all coming from? So realistically speaking, only the third boy stood. The fourth boy left. I don't know who that was. Then we get in a store. So they leave us with a friend, one of the boys that he came with. I'm not name dropping. So if it get confusing, just like, I'm gonna try to keep it as like simple as possible. So he left us in a store with one of his friends. So he left. The two boys left and they went outside to go make their intros, but nobody mentioned nothing about making an intro. They just left and left us in the store. So cool, we waited in the chicken spot for an hour and then we moved up to the next corner. So we was in the corner store. They went and got sandwiches, food, all this other stuff. So then we finally leave. He finally done with the intros. We finally all get up. So now it's three boys and it's me and my friend. So boom, we walk in and we get there. He live in the peas. I don't have no problem with nobody living in a project, but you cannot live in a project and think that you're gonna play with me. So boom, we walk in the building. I have a video.
Yo, if it's one thing I hate, y'all, it gotta be the peas. Word to my dad, this is disgusting.
Yes.
Nah.
Hold on, I'm gonna put the video. I have to go find it actually. The lobby is flooded with piss and water. That should have been the third red flag to turn around. But no, we stood. Your mistake was jacking that you cute. No one, we know where you live. And if I was trifling, you would have been done for. But I'm not trifling because I know you didn't kill. I know you didn't touch me. And I know you're gonna watch this with your friends. And I don't give a nothing. I don't give none of that. Feel how you feel about it. Because when I texted you and feel me, I'm gonna get into that. But when I texted you and asked you what was up, you was fronting like you ain't say nothing whole time. You was texting my man, telling him this and the third. Are you dumb? And I got message proof of that too. I have the receipts. So boom, y'all. We get inside the house or whatever. Then it's his crib or whatever, right? Not his crib, pause. It's his mom crib or whatever. So we in there, we cool. We get in the crib. You know, me and my friend, we like this. We not separating. So we sitting on a edge of the bed. Me and my friend right next to each other eating our food that we just got because we had a whole 4 hour spare time while we was waiting for y'all. So we ended up getting food. So we sitting up there waiting, eating our food. So we lollygagging, everybody laughing. It's cool, it's a vibe. I'm thinking we about to be chilling for real. Like, cause you know, we don't collab with people. This was our first collab with people we met off the internet. And cool, he reached out for the collab. He could never say, you want my name for clout, y'all collab for clout. We never did none of that. Cause he reached out for clout. I mean, not for clout, he reached out for a collab. So at the end of the day, like, I just feel like you're a weirdo. Boom, scratch that. So we fast forward, we all in the crib, we talking, we chilling. He's sitting on the corner of the bed and we laughing with his two friends. So the boy that originally hit us for the collab doing his own thing in his own world while we were his friends. So whole time we filmed like 5-6 videos that day. The crazy part is they're tucking. Matter of fact, I'm not even gonna do that. I'm not even gonna say that because I fuck with the friends. So the friends, we're gonna strictly talk about the weirdo. So we in the crib or whatever, we got, I don't even remember what video we filmed. Oh, we filmed the hot seat video first. Recorded that. Oh, anyways, I named y'all by accident, y'all. So we recorded a hot seat video with one of his friends. The friend has nothing to do with this. Well, I don't know what the friend has to do with anything, but from my understanding, he was cool, like, feel me, whatever the case may be. So we filmed the hot seat video, and then mind y'all, the boy for the collab didn't hit up me. He hit up my friend, but me and my friend, the generation that we in, bro, I'm not letting her go nowhere randomly to go link nobody by herself. So it's either you say yes to me and my friend coming to the collab, or it's no collab. So boom, he understood that. So we linked up. It was three of us. It was supposed to be all three of us. It ended up being five of us. Cool, still not a problem. But when we finished with the hot seat video, then everybody wants to start making their own separate videos. So I have message proof from the whole time. I can show you our dates, everything. I'm texting Jeremiah. I'm texting Tori. Even though me and Tori sitting right next to each other, we text each other like, oh, this is weird. They're being weird. He's being weird. I'm thrown off. This, that, and the third. I'm even texting Jeremiah like, oh, this is kind of awkward. Like, it's giving weird. Like, I'm uncomfortable from the moment I walk in to, like, an hour or two. We was with them for like 6 hours just vlogging, recording, chilling, all this other stuff, right? So at the end of the day, I'm uncomfortable, but I'm not thinking nothing of it because I feel as though I'm only uncomfortable because I've never done nothing like this before. So I'm trying to get the hang of it and stuff, but I was trying to get the hang of it, yada yada, whatever the case may be. So me and my roommate, we did the hot seat challenge. After we did the hot, mind you, the hot seat wasn't even bad. Like, he wasn't really asking us no uncomfortable stuff. We already made it clear that our penalty was nothing like crazy. Even when we first started recording the video, they were trying to get us, oh, well, post him on your story and say he's your boyfriend, or do this or do that, or fit. No, none of that. We cleared the air fast. So the penalty ended up being push-ups, jumping jacks, taking your wig off, all this other stuff. It was nothing freaky, nothing weird, right? So after we finished the hot seat video, this is when the point where everybody starts spitting up into their own video. So we all in the room together. His little brother keeps coming in and out the room, so he closed the door. I guess that was his excuse to close the door, whatever the case may be. Didn't think nothing of it, y'all. Until we all sitting in there, everybody trying to figure out what the next video idea gonna be. So everybody started getting up. My friend and his two friends start getting up to leave. So I start getting up to leave. He's like, no, you're staying in here. What do you mean I'm staying in here? So I text Tori, like, what's going on? So long story short, they made us split up, and she went in the living room with his friend, and I was in the room with him. Again, I'm not thinking nothing of it because, like, we're collabing, but we never agreed to split up. But as long as we was in the same house, it was cool. We was texting the whole time. In the video that he posted, he literally told me, get off of my phone. But I can't show y'all that because then that's gonna be me name dropping. Maybe I could, like, cut a clip and put the voice over on it and, like, just blur the name, like, blur the voice or something. But long story short, y'all, we was in two different rooms. So then we in the room, he's telling me, like, this, he already had this planned, y'all. He had this shit planned because, look, when he put the intro to his video, the nigga said, oh, I got a girl coming over to my crib right now. It's the title of the video was, I'm not even gonna tell y'all what it was, but it had background of me coming over at 2 a.m. No, the fuck didn't. Are you dumb? I was in my own crib at 2 a.m. We linked up with these niggas at 6 p.m. 6 p.m. Are you dumb? Like, I even told my mom. Everybody knew where I was at. My location was on everything. Everybody knew where I was at because we went to go collab. My mom knows that I do YouTube. My mom knows I be networking. So we went to collab. So it's already cool. The boy already had this shit in his head because he did his, like I told y'all, they left us outside in the store to go do their intros. His intro was like, I got a girl coming over right now. Why you didn't mention my roommate? Why you didn't mention the fact that we was both together? And it was killing me is that he texted her to collab and she ended up mentioning me, and then me and him ended up making a video, but it was never supposed to be that because he was supposed to make a video with my roommate. So disregard that. We in the room and the video was whack. It was like, the video was whack. It was nothing. It was not interesting. I watched the video with my roommate. It was funny because I was laughing. Like, I was even dubbing him in a video. He's trying to give me a kiss. He's telling me we look good together. I said, no, we don't. We don't go together. We're not nothing. So we making a video, whatever the case may be. I'm still uncomfortable the whole time. I'm still texting my roommate. And it's like, I'm putting on a facade for the video because I'm not going to be a weirdo in the video. I'm smiling, I'm laughing, I'm joking. Yes, I'm giving back the energy. But whole time, I'm uncomfortable and I have message proof. Literally, I'm literally going to add everything on the screen. So fast forward, leaving his crib, he is a weirdo. And then it's like, you're not even my type of man. Yeah, we was literally in his crib. We literally watched. I'm not even going to bash you. But you know, I'm not even a messy ass bitch, but you know, that's all I'm gonna say. So fast forward that, y'all, he texts me on Instagram after we leave. Mind you, we had to keep making excuses to leave because they keep trying to do, like, he's trying to do more stuff. No, we got somewhere to go. So we leave, whatever the case may be. Y'all, why, as soon as we leave with them or whatever, right? So we leave with them, whatever, we all get on the train. They're going to some function, and me and my roommate are going to Harlem. So we all on the train together. We all taking the train to Manhattan because they're going to Queens, and we going to Harlem. So we on the train, we talking, we vibing. I'm like, yeah, like, y'all cool as fuck. Like, I did not think, like, yo, I'm really real life telling these niggas, like, yo, y'all cool. Like, y'all really changed my insight on collabing with people. Mind y'all, I'm still, the two people that I don't have no issues with, y'all know I'm not bashy. I have no problem with y'all. But y'all friend, y'all know he's a weirdo because, like, feel me? I'm not even gonna sit there and insult nobody, but y'all know it's cooked, y'all know it's tea. So we was on the train, I'm vibing, we was laughing at the clips, watching the clips, all this other stuff. We real life chilling. I'm thinking we cool, I'm thinking we about to collab again. Then they talking about we gonna link up tomorrow, make more videos. Okay, cool, we fuck that. But here's what threw me off. After we leave, he texts me and he's like, send me your number. So I sent him my number because it's like, I have everybody else's. I'm like, feel me? Like, we cool. Like, I'm not about to be weird. So yeah, we're texting. The moment that we start texting, let me back out the text messages. Give me a second. Hold on. All right, y'all. So it's here. Don't think I'm lying about anything. Everything is here, right? So I'm going to add some of the messages on the screen, but I'm going to read y'all the messages so y'all really see what's going on. He hit me. He texts me, asking for a number, so I sent him the number. So clearly he's going to start the conversation. He said, yo. I said, yo. He said, you good? I said, yeah, I'm at my grandma's house. Mind you, y'all, I told y'all we went to Harlem. But that's besides the point. I had a little bit of technical difficulties, y'all. But anyways, I said, are you guys okay? You guys be safe. He said, I'm good. Thank you. I said, let me know when y'all get where y'all going safe. He said, how was it today? I said, it was cool. It wasn't what I expected. It was what I expected. You're a weirdo. Okay? Okay. It's taking it, honey. Okay? I said, like, y'all was cool. The vibe was there. Hold on. Let me crop the number out. The conversation, this is where the screenshot end, right? So scroll to the next one. It was cool. Wasn't what I expected. What time are we doing everything together? I mean, tomorrow, because remember, we're supposed to do a video again. He said, what you mean? It wasn't what you expected. I said, like, y'all was cool. The vibe was there. It wasn't no weird energy or nothing. Make sure you edit that video and post it. I want to tap in. I got you. But stop acting like that towards me saying you got a man. What do you mean? What do you mean? What? Mind you, y'all know kids do not lie. His little brother bust in the room talking about he got a girlfriend. Your little brother was running his mouth about your business the whole night. He was running his mouth. Kids do not lie. So I said, you have a girlfriend. Big and bold. You have a girlfriend. Okay? I deadass don't. I swear to God. Yeah. He posted his girlfriend like 3 days after all of this too. I have the screenshot too. I might put it in here, but then I might figure out who it is. But who's gonna say what? Anywho, I said, don't be lying to me. I said, let me know the time before I go to sleep. I don't want to hear you say we baited. Because after this, I had no intentions on continuing the conversation outside of this. I just continued it because I'm thinking we about to collab, about to figure things out, situated for tomorrow. Okay, cool. He said, bro, if I had a girl, I would not be in a video with you in my crib. You're a liar. So, next screenshot. I said, you're a YouTuber. She knows what's up. He said, they don't. I said, kids don't lie. He said, what kids? Your brother. Stop playing stupid. So, he said, you really chatting, right? So, he said, so why you was acting for real, trying to act? I don't like you got these niggas, though. Not gonna lie. I said, I don't have niggas in real life. In his video, he went through my phone. And he put it on the camera. It was nothing in my phone. I'm not the female who's going to talk to 100 niggas. Like, it was nothing in my phone. My phone is clean. I gave you my phone clear as day. You've seen it for yourself. It was nobody in there. He said, I want you all to myself. I can't have that. I said, I showed you my phone. He said, yeah, you did. Let me show y'all. I'm going to add the screenshot on the screen so y'all can read it on your own. But I'm reading it to y'all so y'all understand. So we scroll. We having casual conversation, but he's a weirdo. I should have picked up on the signs. Y'all, he's telling me he wish he could get in a shower with me. He know I need some head. He want to give me head. You're a weirdo. You don't know me. I told him you invite me back to your crib.
I literally told you yesterday. I don't like you. Cool. I spoke with you. The vibe is there, but I don't know you. Like, and you don't know me. I could be a serial killer. You could be a serial killer. Put some thought into what you say. Like, come on. You don't know me. Like, know me first before you, like, you feel me?
First of all, you bringing me to your crib first that you met me, my homegirl, was the first mistake, because we could have been the back door. Somebody could have sent us to you. You're stupid. You'd never bring nobody you don't know to where you lay your head at. We in the crib. After we leave the crib, he trying to get me to come back. Talking about something he know I need head. Yo. Come spend the night with me. Let me show y'all what I said. Because look, the first time he asked me to spend a night with him, I told him, like, you asked me to spend a night with you. You don't know me. I could be a serial killer coming to kill you and your family. You don't even know. So he keep just going and going. So let me cross his number out. I'm going to have to crop the screenshot a little bit first. Okay, hold on. So that y'all don't see his number, because I'm not messy. It's not working, though. Okay, I'm going to just show y'all like this. Y'all see, it says, but come spend a night, right? And let me show you the end of the message. With me, okay? First of all, this is what I said. Let's vibe. Oh, I put the number. Hold on. Let's vibe. I said, mind you, y'all, I would never talk to this boy. Look at me and look at you. Like, cool, you get a little bit of money. You do what you do. But you're not my type of man. Like, you're not my type of man. Look at the whole time I'm texting back because I want to keep it cordial. Because you going, like, feel me? I want to collab. I want to come up on YouTube. Like, I feel like I, like, feel me? So, I'm trying to be cool and calm about it. So, I'm real life, like, texting back. But I literally have messages of me telling Tori, like, I'm not feeling him. Like, I would never talk to him. But I'm texting him back because I don't want to kill the vibe. Like, I don't want it to be like, oh, like, you're weird. And cut the whole conversation. And now nobody could collab with nobody. Because his friends is cool as shit. Now I could collab with his friends, but not him. But, like, at that time, we wasn't, like, we had just met. I'm crossing my fingers. At that time, we had just met. So if I would have deaded it with him, it would have deaded it with his friends too. But like, you know. So look, y'all, I'm not even gonna say too much. What did I say? What does that say? What does that say, y'all? For him to bash me and to lie on me and lie on his about me, knowing that I know your government, knowing that I know your, knowing that I know your friends, knowing that I know all that stuff, is dumb. You're dumb. You're stupid. And if my mother didn't raise me right, and I was trifling, you would have been done for. Are you dumb? Like, y'all really gotta, like, y'all gotta stop. Like, I never, like, do not get coochie. What are you lying on your man for? Like, are you? I can't even really. I could show y'all this message, but I'm gonna have to blur it a little bit because his name is in it, right? So I said, okay. Let me zoom in. Okay. His name is in it. Okay, I just got home, right? Matter of fact, I'm going to just add this screenshot so that y'all can see it and read it by yourself. I'm going to put it, like, right there. And y'all just read it by yourself, and y'all figured I'm going to just blur out boy name. He says, good, come over when I get back. Come sleep with me. I say his name. I disregard the message. I say his name. He says, yes. I said, what you doing? He said, nothing. Almost there. Almost to the party that he was going to, right? He says, why are you not answering my question? I said, I did already. He said, you said blank, blank being his name. I brought down my message and put an arrow. Let me get to know you first. I could show you that. Let me get to know you first. Boy gonna say, you wanna get to know me first before you spend the night? Are you dumb? Are you fucking stupid? Yo, oh my. Sorry, like. Yeah, this shit is crazy, y'all. This shit is crazy. I said, I'm not a just gonna, you know. He said, bro, it's none of that. I said, no. I said, I'm saying in general, I just want to come know you before I just come lay up in your bed on that, you know. He said, I know, but come on, I ain't no weirdo, but now I feel what you're saying. So you're saying, like, months? Y'all, this man had the nerve to ask me if it's gonna take me months or days to come lay up in his bed. I said, nah, I'm knowing, and I don't know, I just met you earlier, let me see what's up first. He said, nah, yeah. So then this is what he says, y'all. Mind you, he has his girlfriend stalking me and my friend. I'm probably gonna find the messages on TikTok. She get to following us, viewing our page, texting us. Girl, are you, like, he posted the girl, y'all. And the girl came and found us on TikTok, and he texted me, right? He said, I might have to eat it tonight. I said, oh, wow. Are you dumb? Boy, tell me if anybody text me for fake page, don't entertain it. I said, LMFAO, what? I don't do the messy shit. Not getting into it, so handle all of that. He said, nah, you straight. I said, what they saying? He said, who's that girl, this and that? I'm just leaving her in my DM. I said, let me see. Don't throw me off. I was already thrown off at this point. So forget about all the rest of the conversation. Yeah, you guys could see for yourself that he's a weirdo, right? I told you we were supposed to link up tomorrow to do the next video or whatever. So we were supposed to link up at 2. It's about 6 o'clock and he's baiting. I'm lying to him. I'm telling him I had to put the baby to sleep. My mother's kids are grown. All my mother's kids are grown. We don't have no baby in the house. So for me to have to make up a lie for you to leave me alone about coming to see you is crazy. Because, like, men scare me. Let me tell you one thing about it, two things for sure. When people run down on me in the streets and stuff like that, most of the time I've disregarded. But if you scare me, I'm going to give you my Instagram or my number so you can leave me alone because I don't want to be a victim. Like, so boy tells me 6 o'clock valid. I said, my bad, I was putting the baby to sleep. Then, remember, I told y'all, I'm not linking nobody without Tori, right? So I said, don't try to rush me after you bait or whatever. And then we going back and forth. Hold on, let me see. He's begging me to call my mom to see what my mom is doing. Then he says, hold on, y'all. I'm mixing up the screenshots. Oh, I said, I'm waiting to see what Tori fucking with. He said, what you mean, bro? Now you waiting for her to see what's up? I said, yes. He said, so y'all was never ready. I said, no, we've been ready. But at this point, Tori wasn't.
Mind you, I was never going.
Never.
I was never going.
Never. Never. I was just about to say that. Tori already said she wasn't going at this point, but we was just like giving him the runaround because we already said we not coming and you keep pressing us to come. So now I'm like, I'm thinking about it. Whole time we not thinking about nothing. Me and Tori laid back. We is not coming out the crib. So I'm whole time I'm lying to him about the baby. It's no baby in my house, y'all. It's no baby. I'm sending Tori. Me and Tori are literally, I'm going to do a part two because I'm going to put the text messages of me and Tori. We're laughing at this man. Are you dumb? Laughing at this man. So I'm telling him my mother getting her hair done. My mother's in her bed. Like, what? He said, nobody text you, right? I said, is it your girlfriend? Get your girlfriend. So then, boom, right? Boom. Let me tell y'all about when I found out he was jacking, he killed. This was about a week later. A week later, I'm in a crib with my friends, getting at me, yelling at me. I'm not even about to name drop everybody. I'm not name dropping nobody. Scratch that. He hit me like, yo, like, how you know boy? I'm like, oh, I don't know boy. And then I got a video. Hold on, y'all. I'm going to add the clip of me saying, I don't know boy. And Tori linking up, and we're going to go film a video with somebody. I'm going to include, like, all his stuff, y'all. We don't really, no, she knows the boy. I don't know the boy, but, you know, we networking and stuff. So, boom, scratch that. He asked me how I know boy. I tell him I don't know boy because I don't know him. He's like, this is exactly what he did. He said, you and him. I said, me and him what? What? Because this is scissoring. You mean, did we? No, because we didn't. We did not. So I'm like, why you ask me that? He's like, Manai, like, feel me that you don't gotta lie. Like, what do you mean I don't gotta lie? What do you mean I don't gotta lie? So I'm like, what are you talking about? So he tells me, he's putting me on. He's like, yeah, boy calling people. Mind you, when we was in his crib, y'all, I called my friend because we was going through each other's Instagrams, like all of us to see who knew who. And he knew one of my friends, so I called one of my friends. He hit one of my friends like, oh, I'm going to hit you. But I didn't think nothing of it because when my friend FaceTimed us, we were sitting on the couch and it was nothing going on. So he like, I'm going to hit you. So after this, the whole time when he hit my friend, this is when he was jacking, right? So he's telling me, my friend telling me, oh yeah, like he said that he sniped and he killed and you came over by yourself and he, you, what? First of all, I came over with my homegirl. Second of all, you couldn't even get a hug out of me. You couldn't even get a kiss. You couldn't even get a like, I got the, on camera, I'm hitting you on these. Like, I'm not even let you, like, feel me? So I don't even remember where I left off. That's how heated I am. Hold on, y'all. My stuff's not even loading, but long story short, my friend, like, you don't gotta lie, none of that. So I'm like, bro, we didn't do anything. So my friend's like, oh, I don't want you to say nothing because I don't want you to, like, feel me? I don't want to be in nothing. And it's cool, I get it, because you know? So I didn't use his name, but I definitely addressed it. So I texted him, I called him 3 times. He declined my call. I knew what was up when you declined my call. So I texted him like, yo. He put a question mark. I said, answer real quick. He said, just text. I said, it's real quick. I have mad shit in my hand. He goes, nah. I said, okay, hold on. Why did Tori just call me telling me that you telling niggas you fuck me? He said, bro, what? Is you good? Are you out here? I said, are you out here jacking you fuck me? He said, I ain't a kid, bro. Negative. Not my body. You smack, bro. No funny shit. He said, hold on. I said, so it's just mad niggas lying on blank name. I said his name. He said, clearly, what the fuck, bro? I don't talk about you, so believe them, right? I said right. I'm just making sure because don't. I'm just making sure because you fucking me. Never the case. Don't. I said don't be out here jacking that. He said never. Imagine. Never. Like I said. So he proceeds to say I fuck mad bad bitches. Why out of all will I say I fuck you? You dumb as fuck. I said I don't give a fuck about what bad bitches fuck. I'm just making sure you're not out here jacking. You snipe anything because I'm not having it. Just making sure you're not another lame liner. Have a good night. Cleared his ass, y'all. I cleared that man, right? Moral of the story is don't be lying on your dick with a bitch of like me. Are you dumb? And let